Over this past weekend, we finally saw what the Broncos can use to win them some games on this last stretch. This is focusing heavily on the backfield and their rushing attack, specifically in their outside zone sweep plays. They had major success over this past weekend running all over the Dolphins. I'm going to get into the film breakdown and show you guys why I think if the Broncos stay committed to this rushing attack, they can win a lot of games down this last stretch. Taking a look at this first play, we're going to see a variation of the Broncos outside zone, and it's a pin and pull sweep concept here against the Dolphins' double A-gap front, and they're going to have a rolled safety down to the front side. This play torched the Dolphins all game long. I'm going to show you why. So we're going to see here, starting on the front side, the tight end's going to block back to seal the front side backer. This is going to free up the tackle to pull around and kick out the defensive end. Then we're going to see the right guard here block down on that A-gap defender. And this is going to free up the center to pull around and be the lead blocker on the front side safety. Then we're going to see the backside left tackle and left guard basically just reach and try to seal off that backside backer and that backside A-gap defender. So as we see at the snap of the ball, the picture's looking really good here. So starting here, circled in white, we see the kickout block is getting movement on the defensive end. It's starting to expand the gap. We're going to see that the circled in white as well at the top of the screen, the number two above his head, is Noah Fant sealing that backer inside. And as we can see, this gap is starting to expand. The center's going to lead through right up to that front side safety. And as soon as you got an offensive lineman on a safety, it's over. And we see the hole is huge. Phillip Lindsay follows the guard through, bursts right through for a nice gain. So let me run it from the top one more time so we can see it happen in full speed and just show how deadly this play can be. Taking a look at this next play, we're going to be looking at that exact same pin and pull scheme. This time, though, we're going to see the Dolphins are going to try to defend it a little differently. But instead of running two A-gap defenders, they're going to have 2-3 techs, and they're going to run blitz to the front side here. So as we see pre-snap, this run blitz is going to basically be with the safety and the defensive end. The defense end is going to slant inside to the inside shoulder of the tight end, hopefully to get his shoulders turned inside, and it'll hopefully give a free release to the safety to hit the running back in the backfield, obviously. But we see the blocking scheme for the Broncos is going to completely counter this and is actually going to play into what the Broncos want here. With that defensive end slanting inside, it's going to make it super easy for this tight end on the front side to pin him in. That front side tackle is going to pin down the three tech, and then we'll see that front side guard, he's going to pull around and kick out and be the answer to kick that safety out of the play. We're going to see the center also have nobody to down block on, so he's going to pull around and be the lead blocker on that front side backer. We're going to see the backside guard block back on that three tech, and we're going to see this backside tackle, he's going to pull around and be another lead blocker. Finally, we're going to see the tight end here seal back on that backside defender. So now we see at the snap of the ball, the Dolphins actually play this pretty well. We see circled in white, this front side backer does a really nice job scraping over the top, getting in front of these pulling guards here, and it's going to force Phillip Lindsay to take this inside lane here. Now we see circled in orange, we got three Dolphins defenders here ready to make a play on this. We see this backside backer here, he actually has nobody blocking him, so he has a really good shot at tackling Lindsay. Now we see Lindsay's burst is just elite. He gets right out of there, gets cruising, picks up a really nice gain here. Once again, I'll run it back from the top so we can see it all happen at full speed. Just another way the pin and pull sweep can dominate a defensive scheme. So we've seen the pin and pull concept work against multiple fronts and really dominate the Dolphins all game. For this next play, though, we're going to flip gears and take a look at another dynamic of the Broncos rushing attack, and that's their power running game here, especially defeating the Brian Flores' favorite play, one of his most common plays, is cover zero blitz, basically meaning everyone's on the line, everyone's coming, we're sending the house. So like I said, the Broncos are dialing up a really nice power running concept here. We're going to see from the tight end all the way down to the center, they're basically going to all down block and wash all these defenders down inside. We're going to see this backside guard is going to pull around and kick out the stand-up backer here, really allowing the running lane to crease. We're going to see this backside tackle. He's just going to hinge, protecting from the B-gap to the C-gap. So we see at the snap of the ball, the picture's really looking good right now. We see the box off here, the walls form, and the front side's getting a lot of movement on these front side defenders. And we see circled in orange now. We see the pulling guard's getting a really nice kick out on that stand-up backer. Melvin Gordon sees the running lane start to crease here. He sees green grass, and we all know what he does. He hits the gas pedal, gets into the second level. He's going to make a really nice move here on the DB and falls forward for a nice pickup. Once again, I'm going to run it from the top just so we can see another way the Broncos can defeat defenses with a rushing attack. Staying on the same page of power running and adding another dynamic to the Broncos offense, we're going to look at another way the Broncos can use their power rushing attack to defeat another defensive front. And this time, we're going to be focusing on how it can defeat the bear front. So we see pre-snap here, like I said, the Dolphins are in their bare front. So the Broncos are going to dial up a nice power running play here. We're starting on the front side. We're going to see the tight end. He's going to block all the way back and seal that stand-up backer inside. We're going to see this tackle here. He's going to down block on the three tech. The guard here is going to down block on the nose tackle. The center, he's going to block all the way back on the three tech. And then this backside guard, he's going to pull around and once again kick out that stand-up backer. And this backside tackle, he's going to pinch hinge. So he's going to go from B-gap to C-gap. And then finally, before we go too far at ourselves, let's go all the way back to the front side here and see this rolled down safety in the box. The Broncos are going to deal with this by bringing their receiver in to crack block him. So we see at the snap of the ball here, we're going to see inside the tight end, the tackle, the guard. They get really nice movement, walling off these defenders inside, creating that wall. We're going to see circled in orange. We're going to see that pulling guard gets a good kick out on that backer, gets a nice amount of movement on him. And up here on the left side of the screen, we're going to see that crack back by the receiver here. He's going to come, and he's in a really good position here to take out that safety from the play. As we let the play roll, we see actually he doesn't really touch the receiver. This is just Melvin Gordon showing off his burst here, showing off his eliteness in space. He picks up a nice gain. Like I said, I'm going to run it back from the top so we can see it happen in full speed here. Just another dynamic this Broncos can thrive off of in the running game. You've seen the Broncos gash defenses by running these concepts such as the power concept and the pin and pull sweep. We've seen it gash the Dolphins scheme of 2-3 techs, double A gaps, the bare front, and the cover zero blitz. So this begs the question, why isn't this Broncos offense just dominating? Why isn't this Broncos offense scoring 40 points a game then? Well, the simple answer to that question, it's the play calling. This Broncos defense, we've seen the strengths. It's the outside zone sweep concepts. It's the power rushing is their strength. But this play calling is so focused on inside zone that it makes this running game look inefficient. It is embarrassing to watch because this offensive line strength is not inside zone. They're not calling plays to the strength of the O-line. They're calling plays that they want to see work. And flat out, this offensive line struggles to get movement on zone combos in inside zone. They struggle to pick up backers in inside zone. And overall, this rushing attack struggles with inside zone. So that's where it's going to come wrap up the video here, is where I want to see in the second half of the season, I really hope the Broncos can open the playbook and they flip from being an inside zone heavy team to a power heavy outside zone heavy team towards this last stretch. But you know what? Let me know your guys' thoughts. Let me know what you guys think the Broncos will go at the end of the year. Let me know how many rushing yards you think Melvin Gordon and Phillip Lindsay will have. That'll wrap up the video though. I hope you guys enjoyed watching.